always so professional. Yeah. But you're in the cave. Let's loosen the tie.
Take
the top button off. Let's find you. Let's warm you up.
I think I might pull my ear.
Outbreak is over, Dr. Forbes. You can relax. Find yourself a lounge chair over there. Hang out with Niz.
Come on in. The water's
that's
fine.
That's it. Tom Nizzle, Dr. Greg Forbes, and Ryan Davidson are all here this evening. I'm Mike Bettis. Welcome into Weather Underground. Let's show you what is on tap this evening. We have Pesky Petros, 52 and counting, and already sprung. First up, it is Pesky Petros. Our 16th named winter storm of the season is still hanging around. Could make for some rough travel tonight. We're going to show you the spots that are in store for up to half a foot or more of snow. Plus 52 and counting, that's the number of preliminary tornadoes from our two-day outbreak that stretched from Texas to Pennsylvania. Tonight, where it ranks among the biggest February outbreaks to ever strike the United States. And has spring already sprung? Temperatures will soar 25 degrees above average in the coming days, but it comes with a price. We show you how March will likely come in like a lion. Going deep into all those stories on Weather Underground tonight. First, though, we've got the Midwest into the Northeast still dealing with Winter Storm Petros. Our winter weather expert Tom Nizzle here to walk us through this. We thought yesterday we might wash our hands of this thing. I think a lot of people did, but it's still hanging on, the last vestiges of it.
It's some pesky snow, but it's occurring at rush hour right now, and I'm always concerned about major interstates with some of these squalls that come through. This is it right here in the northeastern part of the country. The rest of the country is pretty quiet right now, but if we take a quick look here at the radar, and I'm going to bring this in and zooming in a little bit here. Let's just take a look at what is going on right now. And you can see from Buffalo down through Pittsburgh, down into West Virginia, there is a couple of bands of heavier snowfall. The visibility has dropped to a quarter mile in a couple of these locations.
You know, if we go down into a place, say, like Pittsburgh, Tom, we've got traffic happening for us right now. We can show you the camera in Pittsburgh. That's what it looks like. It's not a fun drive this evening in Pittsburgh. How much longer for a place like Pittsburgh?
You probably got an hour and a half to 2 hours in Pittsburgh. Now, I'm always concerned about the I-80, the Penn Turnpike corridors in here, because quick bursts of snow can slicken it up quickly and traffic moves very fast here.
Right.
They've been known for accidents, so take your time, leave some distance between you and the vehicle ahead of you.
The winds have slackened a bit, though, correct? So we're not nearly as bad as we were yesterday with the winds.
I've not seen as much in as far as wind gusts as we have seen in the past 24 hours, so that is the good news there. If we go ahead and we take a look at how much more snow we expect over the area, and we'll bring this back a little bit here. Most of the snow, of course, is going to occur on northwesterly winds, and those northwesterly winds are going to come up right along the slopes of the Appalachians here, and that's why we've got 5 to 8 inches here. The higher elevations in the Alleghenies and up into upstate New York, probably 3 to 5 inches more, so just be careful if you're traveling through these areas tonight.
All right, Tom, thank you for the update.
Yeah.
We heard that freight train sound.
It's right in front of us. It's going to cross right in front of us. Look at that.
Oh, my God.
It just went right on top of us, man.
A tornado just came through right now. Just tore this place to pieces.
It was so scary. The glass doors blew out behind us and just covered us.
We took cover in the RV park.
It looked like a blender.
I watched a baby doing like this.
She was like flying out the window. I had her by her ankles.
Just incredible images from 2 days of deadly and destructive tornadoes. The stories of survival, just as incredible. It's only February, but back-to-back days of deadly tornadoes leave communities in ruin.
Unbelievable. I mean unbelievable.
In Waverly, Virginia, an EF1 tornado killed two men and a two-year-old child, all found about 300 yards from their mobile home.
This just kind of took our breath away when we got on scene and just saw the devastation.
A third death in South Carolina when a man was hit by a falling tree. And in North Carolina, tornado sirens rang out on the campuses of both Duke and UNC as students took cover.
Holy crap, man!
Meanwhile, the Gulf Coast still reeling after at least 28 tornadoes Tuesday. In Louisiana, ongoing cleanup after a preliminary EF2 tornado tore through an RV park, killing two.
The glass was breaking. You could hear things flipping around outside. I mean, just total carnage.
And daylight revealed the scope of the damage near Pensacola, Florida, after an EF3 tornado hit after dark.
And then I watched her, like, literally the baby doing like this.
She was, like, flying out the window, literally. I had her by her ankles.
Pretty remarkable stuff. We're joined now by severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forrest. We joked a little bit at the top of the show here. You needed to relax afterwards. Yeah. You worked pretty hard, though, the past couple days when you see how many tornadoes we've had and exactly what they've done. Your latest estimate now, roughly 52 tornadoes. Could that number even go up?
Oh, yeah. There's still the National Weather Service is out doing damage surveys, not just from the tornadoes from yesterday, but even still from Tuesday. So I've been hard at work this afternoon. And this, the numbers by state here are not up to date. This is what we started the afternoon with. We're up to 52 tornadoes now. For example, there's two in Pennsylvania. And that is almost unheard of for the month of February.
It's really remarkable. Take a look at February now. So we take a look. Again, the numbers keep changing minute by minute,
yeah,
so the
really
graphics
do.
Are even outdated just minute to minute. But to date, 30, the numbers are way above average now for February.
Yeah, with 52 tornadoes, that's more than the monthly average for the whole month is 35. So we're getting close to double or close to three times the monthly average, and we're 40+% above average for the year.
And where we stand then for the year stands at 70. That's not, is that, that counting?
Well, it's more, 70 is the average. We've gone above 100 now.
So we're
in
going
terms
over 100
of, yeah.
now. Uh-huh. Quick question for you. Do you feel like the spring season has now already begun? Because it seems like we're getting a tornado outbreak about once a week now, once every 10 days or so.
Yeah, it really does feel like we're into spring with a big low-pressure systems, very strong jet stream, but enough warmth and moisture feeling like spring in many cases, and that combination does give us tornado outbreaks.
And we've seen it, boy, yesterday and the day before, really just a mess. Dr. Forbes, thank you very much. And during this week's tornado outbreak, our experts obviously glued to the radar. You probably were as well. But how does a radar tell you there's a tornado? Learn the ins and outs of analyzing a radar so that you can see the danger for yourself. Dr. Forbes and I are going to help you out when we head up to the weather lab for a little Doppler Radar 101 tonight. Also ahead on Weather Underground, the big weekend warm-up for tens of millions of Americans. We're going to show you where it'll feel more like late April than late February. And also our video six-pack for you tonight. We have no shortage of amazing storm video like this time lapse of an incoming storm. Find out where it lands in our countdown later this hour.
If you have high blood pressure like I do, many cold medicines may raise your blood pressure. That's why there's Corsedin HBP. It relieves cold symptoms without raising blood pressure. So look for powerful cold medicine with the heart. Corsedin HBP.
Carrabba's only knows one way to do Italian. Fresh, made from scratch. And now we've added over 20 new dishes. That's why the entire menu is 20% off, so you can try them all. Carrabba's. This is how you do Italian.
The challenges facing the country never stop. So neither does the U.S. Army. We train, adapt, and get smarter. Every soldier, every unit, every day. Not to keep up with change, but to drive it. Nobody knows what problems tomorrow will bring, but we do know who will solve them.
If you have type 2 diabetes, you may know what it's like to deal with high and low blood sugar. Januvia sitagliptin is a once-daily pill that, along with diet and exercise, helps lower blood sugar. Januvia works when your blood sugar is high and works less when your blood sugar is low. Because it works by enhancing your body's own ability to lower blood sugar. Plus, Januvia by itself is not likely to cause weight gain or low blood sugar, hypoglycemia. Januvia should not be used in patients with type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis. Tell your doctor if you have a history of pancreatitis. Serious side effects can happen, including pancreatitis, which may be severe and lead to death. Stop taking Januvia and call your doctor right away if you have severe pain in your stomach area, which may be pancreatitis. Tell your doctor right away and stop taking Januvia if you have an allergic reaction that causes swelling of the face, lips, tongue, or throat, or affects your breathing or causes rash or hives. Kidney problems sometimes requiring dialysis have been reported. Some people may develop severe joint pain. Call your doctor if this happens. Using Januvia with a sulfonylurea or insulin may cause low blood sugar. To reduce the risk, your doctor may prescribe a lower dose of the sulfonylurea or insulin. Your doctor may do blood tests before and during treatment to check your kidneys. If you have kidney problems, a lower dose may be prescribed. Side effects may include upper respiratory tract infection, stuffy or runny nose, sore throat, and headache. For help lowering your blood sugar, talk to your doctor about Januvia.
Easter is right around the corner. We are super excited. That's why we're here at Burlington. I can't wait to see everybody all dressed up. I know that I can dress the kids from head to toe for under $100. We want to sound good and look good.
Here in the city, parking is hard to find. Seems like everyone drives. And those who do should switch to GEICO because you can save hundreds on car insurance. Oh, perfect. Valet parking. Hello.
Evening, sir.
Here's the keys. And go easy on my right, mate. Wouldn't mind some of that beef Wellington.
To see how much you could save on car insurance, go to GEICO.com.
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about it.
Tomorrow on AMHQ, it's a welcome weekend warm-up, but it could cause some problems for the NHL's Outdoor Stadium Series in Denver. We hit the ice tomorrow, starting at 5, right here on AMHQ.
This is what is meant by a rotational couplet, where you've got wind that is moving away from the radar and going toward the radar.
Ah, good news there. You saw just briefly a little flash of yellows and greens. Now the newest scan has come in and the rotation seems to weaken.
And it does look like there is evidence of debris, so I think we've probably got a tornado ongoing.
See if we have any debris signature left. Maybe it's left some of the debris behind, tossed it up in the air and it's falling out.
We're able to actually see that there is debris being lofted into the air that coincides very well with the circulation in this case.
That, some pretty serious radar analysis from Carl Parker and our Dr. Greg Forbes with our outbreak the last couple of days. Now the question is, how can you be a radar guru like those two? Well, Dr. Forbes is here to kind of walk you through the radar. What we look at when we're looking for tornadoes, Dr. Forbes, there are a lot of different things you can see on a radar.
Yeah, and when you're just looking at the shape of the precipitation pattern, what we call the reflectivity, of course, the optimum storm is one that is a hook echo. So the whole storm spirals around, and then sometimes at the end of the hook, you get what I often call a debris ball, and often the tornado is sitting right inside of that. So that, for one, if you can get that kind of a shape, that is indicating here where the weak echo notch is where the inflow is coming in, and then the precipitation is wrapping all around that. Now, then we can look at the velocities. The reds going inbound, the blues here going outbound. That is what we call a tornado vortex signature. So those, if you look in the velocities, right there where they touch is where the center of the tornado is going to be. So
with the radar, you can look at not only precipitation, but you can take out the precipitation at some point and tell the software, just look at the winds inside the storm.
Yeah, and that's what it's meant by the Doppler velocity. And the strongest opposing wind directions here, where they touch, that's the tornado vortex signature. That's the tornado where you have these broader areas of reds and blues. That's the broader, what we call the mesocyclone, or that sometimes corresponds to the wall cloud visually that we see hanging down from the cloud base.
A lot of times you'll hear on our air the term TVS,
yes.
Which you just, the tornado vortex signature, which is an indication there's a tornado.
That's what we're seeing right here. Then we have additional ways that we can take a look, and you've just heard us talking about these debris signatures, and right in here is this blue. Now, the reds, that's all the precipitation, but these dual parameter radars that we have, they look horizontally, they look vertically. When we have debris in the volume of this beam, it's tumbling, then that shows up as blue. And so that's what we call the debris signature. And that is another way of seeing that there's a tornado in progress, not just that there's velocity. Sometimes that's in the cloud. This says that there's a tornado has kicked up debris.
So when you often look at your TVS and you see that, and then you see this compact area, blues or greens, that to you is a clear signal that there was a tornado.
Yeah, that's a tornado debris signature when it's a ball and it corresponds right to the same location as the velocity's tornado vortex signature, then you know you have a tornado in progress.
And a lot of times there's new wording now on Weather Service tornado warnings. It says tornado confirmed.
Yes.
by Doppler radar.
That's by that debris signature, yeah.
So look for that if you ever are into the warnings that are distributed by the National Weather Service. Dr. Forbes, thank you very much. Great lesson there. And coming up, we're going to take a look at this two-day tornado outbreak by the numbers. We're going to show you the stats that stand out as we break down the aftermath of this powerful storm system. Also counting down the best weather videos of the day, like this scary tornado captured by a traffic cam. Stay with us to see the other tornado videos that made our list. But before we go to the break, let's check in with meteorologist Ryan Davidson back in the weather cave.
Hey, Mike, we're going to be taking your questions next here on Weather Underground, so start tweeting those out using hashtag WooTV, and we're going to answer this question coming up next. Thus far, would you say this year's strong El Nino has been a bust? And the answer lies in some of the things we were talking about earlier this week. We're going to come back with that question, plus a whole bunch more. Don't forget, hashtag WooTV. We'll be back right after this.
Boston Market invites you to enjoy a real meal. Delicious homestyle sides prepared daily, fresh baked cornbread, and of course, our farm fresh, never frozen, all natural rotisserie chicken. Come on in for a half chicken meal, just $8.49. Boston Market, all good.
For a limited time, get a half chicken meal, just $8.49 at Boston Market, all good.
You do all this research on the perfect car. Gas mileage, horsepower, torque ratios. Three spreadsheets later, you finally bring home the one, then smash it into a tree. Your insurance company's all too happy to raise your rates. Maybe you should have done a little more research on them.
For drivers with accident forgiveness, Liberty Mutual won't raise your rates due to your first accident. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Attention, Xarelto and Pradaxa have been linked to internal bleeding.
If you or a loved one took Xarelto or Pradaxa and were then hospitalized for internal bleeding, call the Goldwater Law Firm.
The makers of Pradaxa have agreed to pay $650 million in settlements. If you took Pradaxa or Xarelto and were injured, call us right now.
You may be entitled to substantial compensation. Call 1-800-921-9600. That's 1-800-921-9600.
Home Advisor is a very easy way to find a home contractor, and for me, it's the only way.
Home Advisor instantly connects you with top-rated pros for any type of home project.
If you need it, Home Advisor has it.
And it's completely free. Go to homeadvisor.com now.
Fortifying the gravity-defying, friend-connecting, day-seizing, strong you. New Special K Nourish. Multigrain flakes with quinoa, apples, almonds, and raspberries. New Special K Nourish. Fortify.
I recommend Nature Made Fish Oil because I trust their quality. They were the first to have a product verified by USP, an independent organization that sets strict quality and purity standards.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended fish oil brand.
What makes me a weather geek? That's a great question.
Owning like five weather stations at my house, and then I name them. Who does that?
I have a weather station in the backyard so I can check the dew point, which is my favorite.
I am a nerd. I'm nerdy and proud.
I'm proud to be a weather geek. Be one of the thousands of weather geeks out there at weloveweather.tv.
Find fantasy shows.
When it comes to the things you love, you want more. Love romance? Get lost in every embrace. Into sports? Follow every pitch, every play, and every win. Change the way you experience TV with X1 from Xfinity.
Seaside Music, Technical Productions, and All On Stage present An Intimate Evening with Ambrosia, featuring special guest Martin Dubé. Tuesday, March 1st at 7 p.m. at the Plaza Ballroom and Event Center in North Palm Beach. One night only. Seating starts at only $35 with a VIP experience at $75. An Intimate Evening with Ambrosia. Tickets available at SeasideMusicMGMT.com. For more information, call 561-350-3867.
Tomorrow on AMHQ, it's a welcome weekend warm-up, but it could cause some problems for the NHL's Outdoor Stadium Series in Denver. We hit the ice tomorrow, starting at 5, right here on AMHQ.
Currently in our area, 64 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, mainly clear. Low 49. Winds west-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday, sunny skies. High 71. Winds northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Friday night, clear. Low 49. Winds north-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Here at the Weather Channel, we love it when you show off your stunning weather photos, and none more stunning than this one, a sunset over the Bandalur National Monument in New Mexico. This posted by Andrew Gordon 89 on the Wonder Photos page on wonderground.com. Look at the colors in that. Is that spectacular or what? Well done, Andrew. A good job. You can check out more photos like this again on our website. And coming up, we're going to picture this, an example of how not to ice fish safely. We're gonna show you what's just not right about this icy lake, although you might be able to figure that out for yourself. But we look at the weather behind it coming up as Mark Elliott pictures this. All right, let's sound off now. Dr. Forbes, Tom Nizzle, Ryan Davidson all here. Let's answer your questions tonight. You're sending them in using the hashtag WUTV on Twitter.
Great variety tonight.
All right.
Very good. We've got severe end winter, but we're going to start with Darren, the question we were talking about earlier.
All right, Darren, I appreciate your question tonight. Thus far, would you say this year's strong El Nino has been a bust? What do you guys think? You guys, it's subjective. What you term a bust?
Yeah, in some ways it's a bust, in some ways not. For Southern California, I think the rainfall has not been what they would normally have expected. But for Florida, we often say that the Florida Peninsula will get tornadoes during El Nino years more than average, and I think that has come to bear.
As far as winter weather goes?
Winter, in particular, the Northeast and the Great Lakes have been warmer than normal, and that would be typical of strong El Nino years. So if you like milder conditions and lower heating bills, it's been a boom, not a bust.
It really has, for sure. Good question.
All right, the next one's coming from Caleb.
All right, Caleb, thank you for your question tonight. Is there potential for a major snowstorm for Ohio next week on March 3rd through the 4th? What do you say, Niz?
It's a good question. The social media world is all abuzz over what could be the next storm. And we're going to talk about this in a few minutes. The models have been going from run to run with big differences right now. So there's going to be a big system in the east next week, but exact location and timing is still, we got to work those details out.
We got a week to go, we could still work out a lot of details in the storm by then.
Next one from Braden.
Braden, all right, thank you for your question. Could the South, specifically Southeast Texas, be looking at another severe outbreak next week? What do you think, Forbes?
Yeah, it certainly can. Just as Tom was saying, the models have been bouncing around, but as it looks right now, there's certainly on Tuesday a threat of tornadoes. Maybe not so big of a threat right in Southeast Texas as Northeast Texas, as I think all the model runs have had the low farther to the north. And so the Southeast Texas area would be farther from that surface low. Maybe not quite as big of a tornado threat a tornado threat,
right,
though.
Okay. All right. Dr. Forbes, thanks. And thanks for your question.
All right. And our last question coming from Sean.
All right, Sean, thank you. All right, here's the question. When you throw boiling water in cold water, does it work with well water? I think he means when you throw boiling water into cold air.
I'm thinking that's what he means,
where we get the ice crystals that form. Go back to that one more time. Let me read it one more time. When you throw the boiling water in cold air, does it work with well water? It doesn't matter.
Well water has a few more minerals in it, but with that heat and evaporation into that cold air, it should still work. But don't throw it right above you because you can...
Because not all of it completely evaporates. Goes over to ice crystals,
right? So be
right?
Very, very careful.
Yep. All right. Thank you for your question tonight. Be careful. We've actually seen some really amazing... People doing art with it now.
Oh,
have you seen...
Beautiful.
You know, the slow motion
absolutely
video
beautiful.
And everything is pretty cool. Thanks for your questions. Keep sending them using the hashtag WUTV on Twitter. We'll answer your questions throughout the show. Well, after a busy week of storms, we can get a break for the weekend, but that break not lasting long. Confidence is now growing on our next storm system. It once again will be a two-parter, bringing thunderstorms to some, snow to others. Tom and Dr. Forbes are going to break it down for you when we come back here on Weather Underground. You just heard him tease it just a little bit. But Tom, you're saying don't put away the snow shovel yet.
Absolutely.
By the way, they were mentioning Ohio, March 3rd and 4th.
Yeah.
Guess where I'm going to be March 3rd and 4th.
Great timing.
Right.
Bring your shovel back home, Mike.
A severe weather symposium that's going to bring us a snowstorm. Yeah. Yeah. Lucky me.
That'll be fun.
Mm-hmm. Gummy bears, by the way, Forbes.
What? Okay, careful.
Oh.
All this stuff.
Such a waste. Gorilla Glue.
Of course.
Gorilla Glue bonds wood, stone, metal, ceramic, and more. Gorilla Glue for the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
Gorilla Glue for the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
Let me talk to you about retirement.
A 401k is the most sound way to go. Let's talk asset allocation.
Sure.
You seem knowledgeable, professional.
Would you trust me as your financial advisor?
I would.
I would indeed.
Well, let's be clear here. I'm actually a DJ.
No way.
I have no financial experience at all.
That really is you.
If they're not a CFP pro, you just don't know. Find a certified financial planner professional who's thoroughly vetted at letsmakeaplan.org. CFP, work with the highest standard.
Now everyone who uses catheters can get a better catheter with Liberator Medical's free catheter sample pack. These new catheters are better than ever. Easier to use, more convenient, comfortable, virtually pain-free. There's the all-new compact catheter. Catheters for women. Small, fits in your purse, ready to use instantly. The pre-hydrated catheter. It lubricates itself in the package. Comfortable, no mess. The polished eyelet catheter for micro-smooth comfort. Reduces friction and pain. The closed system catheter, pre-lubricated with its own collection bag, proven to reduce UTIs. The self-lubricated catheter, water-activated lubrication for slippery smooth comfort. The discreet pocket catheter, curved to fit in your pocket to go anywhere. Call for your free catheter sample pack with free shipping. We'll bill Medicare and your insurance for you. Call Liberator Medical.
Call 1-800-730-9337. 1-800-730-9337.
I've always been protective of my little sister. But when she got cancer, she was the strong one. She learned while she needed chemo.
It could weaken my immune system.
But then you found out about Neulasta.
Right.
Neulasta helps reduce infection risk by boosting your white blood cell count, which strengthens your immune system. In a key study, Neulasta reduced the risk of infection from 17% to 1%, a 94% decrease. Neulasta is for certain cancer patients receiving strong chemotherapy. Do not take Neulasta if you're allergic to Neulasta or Neupogen. Ruptured spleen, sometimes fatal, as well as serious lung problems, allergic reactions, kidney injuries, and capillary leak syndrome have occurred. Report abdominal or shoulder tip pain, trouble breathing, allergic reactions, puffiness in face or ankles, change in urine, swelling of stomach area, feeling of fullness, dizziness, or feeling faint to your doctor right away. In patients with sickle cell disorders, serious, sometimes fatal crises can occur. The most common side effect is bone and muscle ache.
Ellie's strong, but she still needs help.
Yeah, I do.
Ask your doctor about Neulasta.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your dermatologist about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
Brace yourself. The first ever GSF is here with a torque vectoring differential and a 467 horsepower V8 engine. It's the next expression of F performance from Lexus.
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
Closed captioning brought to you by California Walnuts.
What makes this the best simple dinner ever? Great tasting, heart healthy California walnuts. So simple. Get the recipes at walnuts.org.
Let's take a live look right now, Syracuse, New York. A little bit of light snow expected to continue through the night. You may not be able to pick it out exactly there on the camera, but there are a few flakes still flying this evening, all thanks to the tail end here of Winter Storm Petros. But it's definitely a wet evening for you on the roads out there if you headed out to a little dinner tonight. All right, let's check in on your forecast here in the east. Meteorologist Keith Carson is joining us now. Much quieter.
Yes.
Thank goodness. We're not dealing with severe weather, but still a few folks are thinking, oh man, I thought Petros was going to be gone, but it's still hanging on. Just one more night.
In the Northeast particularly, and you know, it's interesting, we had some severe weather in the early morning hours, mm-hmm. and that just doesn't happen
in
New England, so it surprised a lot of people. All right, let's take a look at what we got going on out right now, and you can see some of that snow on the back side of this. So this is, of course, related to our winter storm. A lot of this just kind of snow squall activity, some light snow showers in there as well. Across parts of western New York, in through Tom's stomping grounds there of Buffalo, in through Syracuse, as we just showed you. You know, this is a spot. Ray Stajic, one of our radio guys, was talking about. He went snowmobiling. He schedules a trip every year upstate New York. It wasn't much snow this year, so they're really hurting for it there. West Virginia, by the way, seeing a decent amount of accumulation as well, a lot of that terrain-driven. Temperatures right now, 50 in Boston, 41 in New York, 42 in Philadelphia, and 30 in Binghamton, 28 in Buffalo. So pretty average, although 50, nice, in Boston, still in the warm sector there. All right, let's take a next 20. Are we going retro with this map, Ryan, or are we just missing some
data?
Looks
like data's out.
Okay. Well, imagine that there'll still be snow there, and there'll still be some rain in the warm sector. Look at this cold air coming in, though, behind it. 12 in Burlington, 11 in Bangor, 13 in Binghamton. So we're going to see some strong winds bringing in those northwest, the northwest winds bringing in that cold air. Hey, there we go. All right. There we go. So there's the temperatures dropping. You'll see the snow showers going on with it. So by tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow night, and then into Friday, we'll be in good shape. So let's take a look at the southeast and see if we get any data down there. 48 in Atlanta right now, 38 in Nashville. You know, we've traded what had been a soggy pattern across the southeast for some sunshine, but temperatures are running a little bit below average. They'll actually do that into the weekend with a big ridge of high pressure. And actually, this map is pretty accurate even without the data. There'll be a big ridge of high pressure, nothing really going on. Temperatures will cool down. All right, we'll have a look at the northeast, southeast, Midwest, plains, Middle Earth, all that 30 minutes. Mike?
Remember when you were a kid and your parents said, just use your imagination.
Yeah, that's what happened.
That's what you're doing right there. You're putting that imagination to good use. All right, imagine this weekend, a nice spring warm-up. It's definitely in the cards. Notice what happens this weekend is the jet stream really jumps off to the north here, and so that allows for really warm equatorial air to shoot its way north as well. So I think for a lot of you, you're really enjoying the numbers that you'll see. Jet stream going really almost all the way up to Canada. Warm surface winds will be almost due north here. So here's a look at the temperature forecast. 15 to 30 degrees above average, even as far north as Bismarck, North Dakota. Not too shabby, huh? Well, let's take a look at the forecast highs for Saturday across the southern plains. 73 in Dallas, 72 in Oklahoma City. Like in the forecast on Sunday, almost 80 in San Antonio. We'll do 75 in Shreveport and a 75 for you in Lubbock as well. Fast forward into Monday now. It's the last day of February. 70 in Little Rock, mid-70s for us in Oklahoma City. We continue on Tuesday, although notice the winds now start to transition more out of the north. A change in the weather pattern is coming our way, so heads up on what's coming. And we're gonna dive deep into that here in just a second with our experts. But how about Oklahoma City? We're on the upswing here over the next several days. Truly, I say, maybe the best weekend you've had so far of 2016. Like the numbers here. The forecast off to the Midwest, 54 in Bismarck, 56 in KC, and 42 for you tomorrow in Minneapolis. Still 10 degrees above average. On Saturday, pushing almost 60 in Minneapolis, almost 70 in Kansas City, and 61 degrees, excuse me, in St. Louis. We like the mid-50s for us in Chicago, about 14 degrees above average. So Saturday's highs, Minneapolis, 57. Valentine, Nebraska, almost 70. Goodland, Kansas, mid-70s. And Bismarck, 64. We're near record territory, above record territory in every situation here. All right, let's take you right into Chicago and talk about the temperatures that you've been seeing lately. They've been a little bit on the cool side. It's led to some precipitation. How about accidents on the roads? Several accidents because of icy conditions on those roadways. As many as 50 vehicles stuck overnight in heavy snow along Route 17 in Grant Park. Officially, the city only got 1 to 3 inches of city around the metro. Chicago, though, could be a target of some more snow. But after the weekend warm-up, And we hinted that there was a change in the weather pattern across the south as well. So Tom Nizzle's here. Dr. Greg Forbes is here. Two separate sides of the storm system. Let's start with the severe side first, Dr. Forbes. What do you see happening early next week with our next storm system?
Well, we're going to have a low pressure system develop and push east of the Rocky Mountains. Probably it's going to be in Oklahoma. So that will mean that it's going to pull warm, moist air off of the Gulf of Mexico across central and eastern Texas up into Oklahoma, maybe up into even the southeast parts of Kansas. But there's been a lot of model-to-model variability here. Right. If that scenario holds true, last night the model run said it would. This morning they this afternoon they said it would. This morning they didn't, but that would give some tornado threats. So I've given a Torcon of 3 there for Tuesday for southeast Texas, a little bit higher up closer to that surface low, northeast Texas and parts of Oklahoma and Arkansas and Kansas and Missouri, all a tornado condition index of 4, 40% chance of a tornado within 50 miles. But the models are still what we call bouncing around a little bit, including this morning. They were much different. The jet stream much farther to the north up into Oklahoma. So that meant that the surface low was way, way up, hundreds of miles different up into Iowa. And with that being so far away from the Gulf of Mexico, meant more of a damaging wind threat. The surface low and its rotation so far away from the Gulf moisture that probably thought it was more severe winds than it was tornadoes.
So as of right now, you're thinking likely more likely for southern plains than any other place, right?
I think so, yeah. But maybe some severe all the way up to the western Ohio River Valley.
And Tuesday's a really important day in this country because Tuesday we head to the primaries to vote. Yep. Super Tuesday, and a lot of states are holding primaries. If they aren't seeing severe weather, could they be seeing snow, Tom?
Well, yeah, they certainly could be. And as Dr. Forbes talked about, we're seeing big differences in run-to-run models here. And so if we take a look, earlier today we looked at a forecast where there was going to be a swath of snow that ran from Kansas right up through Des Moines and into Chicago in that Wednesday night time frame. The new model runs came in, and as they did, the whole solution shifted. So we've drawn that line where it was, and now we've
had... This drives you nuts as a forecaster. Forbes is even laughing at you. Yeah. Because he's like, oh, geez.
We were talking about this just a while ago.
It's hard to give an accurate forecast when the computer models want to do this.
And here's one of the reasons why. But Ryan, bring up that European model 500 millibar flow. I want to show you that. That's the forecast there. But bring the next one up. This is the operational European run of the jet stream next week.
Okay.
But we run a whole series of forecasts with this, an ensemble of members. And look at how each member has differed. That jet stream is all the way up towards Chicago and one of the model runs down into Texas with another. There's the challenge that we have in trying to predict the details of the tracks of these storm system, and the track depends on that jet stream. So, Dr. Forbes, this is something that we're going to have to work with over the next few days.
And very, very small differences in that jet stream can mean tremendous amounts in terms of tapping Gulf of Mexico moisture for both severe and the winter side, and to how intense the surface low will be that really squeezes out that moisture.
So what we know is we're going to get a low. We're going to get a major a storm system, but it's the location and timing that we still have to work out with details.
It's coming. But it could be anywhere from the Gulf Coast to the Great Lakes. So anyway, stay with us. We'll keep updating the forecast for you. And still to come on Weather Underground, we're going to show you the numbers behind the damage. Dr. Forbes is back to break down some of the amazing stats of our recent tornado outbreak as we bring you the tornado aftermath. And we're counting down our top videos of the day. How about this one? Fire and snow. Where does it land in our countdown of the top weather videos of the day? You've got to stick around to find out right here on Weather Underground.
Wow, that's a pretty impressive video there.
I liked how both of those solutions, one was definitely more intense of a low, and then the other one, not so much. Like tornadoes.
514 can transmit on.
Andrew. Rita. Sandy. Meet Chris. Jackie. Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
You want to lose weight? Here's some things you should know. Lose up to 3 times more body fat in 1 month than dieting on your own. Weight loss of just 8% can help reduce your risk for heart disease.
Introducing the all-new Turbo 10. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. You'll love it. Money back guaranteed.
Did you know that losing weight on Nutrisystem can help you lower your blood pressure by 7 points in 1 month?
improve your sleep quality by 19% in 1 month.
Lose 7% of your body weight and lower your risk of diabetes by 58%. So you can have more energy, sleep better, and burn more belly fat.
Bust that gut.
My energy level is through the roof.
I sleep so much better.
My doctor is so happy.
Order your 28-day plan right now. With Turbo 10, you'll get delicious meals and 1 week of our all-new Turbo Shakes. Free, packed with protein and probiotics to help support digestive health and bust belly bloat.
The shakes, so good.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
Plus 1 week of our NutriCrush shakes to crush hunger free.
Forget about fad diets. It's important to have the right amount of carbs, fats, and proteins to fuel your body. And Nutrisystem has everything you need.
Yo-yo diet. Forget about it.
Lose weight fast, have more energy, and get healthy.
I absolutely feel sexier now than I did when I was in my 30s.
I gained energy, stamina, endurance.
Now I'm taking the stairs.
Call or click now, and we'll rush you Turbo 10 today with 14 free shakes. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. Money back guaranteed.
I owe my weight loss to Nutrisystem. 100%.
10 years later, and I'm feeling great.
Do what I did. Call Nutrisystem and start looking and feeling great today.
Pick up the phone and call Nutrisystem now.
Call 877-920-DIET right now and get the all-new Turbo 10 with 14 shakes free.
Hey, I'm Ty Pennington, and I've got a simple question for you. Are you paying too much for your mortgage? Well, you won't know for sure until you check with Guaranteed Rate. You can do it right now. It's that easy. With Guaranteed Rate's digital mortgage, you can choose from today's lowest rates, check your free credit scores, and even get approved online. All in just minutes, at no cost to you. Or just call us, and one of our home loan experts will help you find a low, low rate. Lowering your mortgage payment could save you thousands of dollars. Just take a few minutes right now to see how much you could save.
We were going to rent. That was the going-in plan, but the rate was so low at Guaranteed Rate that we ended up buying.
Whether you're buying a new home or refinancing your current home, get a low, low rate from Guaranteed Rate. Call 888-557-1555 or visit grloans.com.
Julie was invited to share her own experience with Liberator Medical. Results may vary.
I wore a Class B bag as a result of a pretty bad injury. When Liberator Medical said, "Why don't you sample out this Coloplasmio?" it was amazing. This one had a charcoal filter, it conformed to my body, it was low profile, and it was a product that I probably would not have learned of if not for Liberator specialists. I don't have to worry about leaking, I don't have to worry about ballooning, I don't have to worry about the way that I move. My activity level has been heightened, spontaneity, confidence especially. I would give Coloplast for the design of the Mio more than attaboy. They'd get a woohoo!
Call Liberator Medical for your free Centura Mio sample pack with free shipping.
Call 1-800-503-7096. 1-800-503-7096.
Time now for our video six pack with meteorologist Keith Carson. We've got a lot of different things because we've had a lot of different weather lately, a couple of different seasons in the same week.
This is, selfishly for me, doing a six-pack is a little bit easier than all tornadoes one after another. Dr. Forbes would do a six-pack with all those, but it's a little bit more challenging. We got a variety. We're actually going to start with, I think we teased this before the break, I'm using the inside biz word. This is Illinois, about 30 miles south of Chicago. Take a look at this. Snap power line led to some fire in the snow. And Mike, correct me if I'm wrong, I feel like we saw this in Massachusetts like 2 or 3 weeks ago.
We did.
Yeah, and I've never seen it prior, but apparently it's a thing that happens when the power line goes down and it quasi catches fire. That's one way to melt some snow there. All right, let's go on to number five. Double rainbow at Penn State College yesterday. Really, really pretty stuff. Of course, they had a variety of weather. Pennsylvania going from severe weather over to some snow there. And pretty much everyone who works at the Weather Channel went to Penn State. Just go look out in the parking lot. You'll see. Actually, don't go look in the parking lot. That's a bad suggestion. All right, number four. Time lapse of heavy rain hitting uptown Charlotte yesterday. And pretty dramatic stuff. Charlotte actually did have some strong gusty winds. We got a lot of good video out of that neck of the woods. They did not end up with any tornadoes there, but they did see some strong storm squall line moving on through. All right, number three, a tornado as it moves across I-55 in Louisiana. This is cool because look at the wind direction at first, going left to right there. Maybe I missed the beginning of the roll. It switches real quick. All right. Yep, I think we buried the lead on that. Anyways, it already switched. But the wind originally was going in the other direction, then quickly switched as that tornado came through. Obviously, visibility very low. If you can see the highway there and a highway there. All right, we want you to vote tonight. Here are your top two choices. We've got a storm time lapse there on the left, and then we have a Louisiana tornado, which there had been some debate about whether or not it was a tornado as of yesterday, but Dr. Forbes has spoken, and the rest of us have listened. Here is a look at the vote so far. So pretty close to Louisiana. A tornado coming in 54. Go on Twitter, vote, and we will get those results for you in less than an hour. Mike?
We're definitely outnumbered here with the Penn Staters.
Yes.
For sure.
Yes.
All right, this week's severe weather outbreak is spanning 2 days. We had storms across more than a dozen states. February tornado outbreaks, not unheard of. Big ones aren't all that common, but let's take a look at some of the preliminary totals that we have. 52 preliminary tornadoes now from our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes. And Dr. Forbes with us here to take a look at the aftermath, if you will, breaking down the disaster by the numbers. When you look at some of the things that happened this week, there were a lot of interesting stats that really stood out, Dr. Forbes. You're about to run through some of these with us, but just you know, looking at the numbers right now, 52. That's a pretty big number.
Yeah, it really is. There's only, I think, maybe two tornado outbreaks that I know of in February that are bigger than that. The Super Tuesday 2008 had 85 tornadoes, but this one is a very, very large one. And this graphic that we're seeing here doesn't fully reflect all the up-to-date counts on that. There's now a second tornado in Pennsylvania and more tornadoes, I think, in Virginia, for example. But this was sort of going into the afternoon. I think there were 48 in that one. We have 50.
Amazing. Let's take you up to Maine here. It's the first February thunderstorm tornado warnings, thunderstorm warnings ever issued by the Portland Weather Service Office or the Caribou Weather Office. Why so difficult to get severe thunderstorms in the winter this far north?
Well, usually it's very, very cold at the surface, and the Atlantic waters out there in the Gulf of Maine are very, very cold typically, so you don't have that warm, moist air coming into Maine like you do coming into Louisiana off the Gulf of Mexico. So you have to have some strong upper air forcing coming through, jet stream, and very cold air, lots of lifting aloft in order to really get thunderstorms in February in Maine.
Let's take it down to your home state here. First winter tornado in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania, 125 mile per hour winds. And we had a second tornado that happened in Bradford County, only the second and third tornadoes ever recorded in February in the state of Pennsylvania since accurate records have been kept.
Yeah, and Bradford is way up in the mountains there, so that's even harder to get tornadoes there at any time of year. Very, very unusual. And these were kind of squall line tornadoes that were coming in there. So big circulations, though. There was a huge swirl coming across that southeast Pennsylvania area there that likely touched off that tornado in Lancaster County.
Now down to Virginia. First ever tornado-related fatality in the month of February. Getting violent tornadoes that kill people in Virginia doesn't happen that often in the winter.
No, it's not at all common. And we had EF3-rated tornadoes up in that area as well. You sometimes think you might get a weak tornado along a gust front, but these were supercell thunderstorms that were rolling up across there.
And another stop here, we'll take you down to Florida. Strongest tornado of the year, 155 miles per hour. This is happening in Escambia County, which prior to this week had the strongest tornado 11 days ago.
And usually in the Gulf of Mexico, you see the tornadoes, but they're usually farther inland. So this close to the Gulf of Mexico, where you haven't had time for the heating farther inland, is very, very unusual.
And by the way, South Carolina, the only state across all the South that actually didn't get a tornado. Stick around. Weather Underground. Be right back.
If you have high blood pressure like I do, many cold medicines may raise your blood pressure. That's why there's Coracetin HBP. It relieves cold symptoms without raising blood pressure. So look for powerful cold medicine with the heart. Coracetin HBP.
Where can you satisfy your craving for a delicious 100% Alaskan cod meal? Right here at Long John Silver's. Enjoy our tasty two-piece hand-battered Alaskan cod basket, hand-dipped in our classic batter, now for just $5.99. Because at Long John Silver's, you deserve more.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week. AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Let me get you ready for the day weather-wise.
We've got a lot going on this morning.
Definitely see what kind of pattern we've had.
So start your morning routine with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jan Carfagna, and the rest of AMHQ.
It is a team here at the Weather Channel and an awesome team at that.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 63 degrees under fair skies. Tonight, mainly clear, low 49. Winds west-northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday, sunny skies, high 71. Winds northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Friday night, clear, low 49. Winds north-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Easter is right around the corner. We are super excited. That's why we're here at Burlington. I can't wait to see everybody all dressed up. I know that I can dress the kids from head to toe for under $100. We want to sound good and look good.
From the moment they wake up, doers don't stop. Every day is a chance to do something great. And for the ones they love, they do anything. Sears Optical has glasses made for doing. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
The moment Sloan was ready to lose weight, she came to Jenny Craig, met her personal consultant, picked from our delicious food, and never had to worry about what to eat.
A moment really can change your whole life with Jenny Craig.
Try us free for a month, plus the cost of food, and get $50 in food savings.
When the doctors don't look you in the eye, you know it's not good. When I went out, I had to put on a wig, I had no hair. But when I got home, I got to take everything off and just be me. 2 days before Christmas, I found out I was cancer-free. We live carefree where we're happy, and that's home.
Whatever home means to you, we'll help you find it. Zillow.
Mesothelioma victims and their loved ones may be entitled to a cash award from the $18 billion in asbestos trust funds. And you may not have to file a lawsuit to qualify. If diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, call the number on your screen now. Even if a loved one had mesothelioma or asbestos lung cancer and has passed, your family may still be entitled to a cash award. Mesothelioma is a rare cancer caused by exposure to asbestos. Many victims worked in the Navy or in shipyards, mills, carpentry, roofing, insulation, construction, or automotive industries. For over 30 years, our legal team has successfully helped thousands of victims and families. Time is limited. You may not have to file a lawsuit if you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos.
Call 1-800-948-6735. That's 1-800-948-6735.
Tomorrow on AMHQ, it's a welcome weekend warm-up, but it could cause some problems for the NHL's Outdoor Stadium Series in Denver. We hit the ice tomorrow, starting at 5, right here on AMHQ.
Welcome back to Weather Underground. I'm meteorologist Mark Elliott with tonight's Picture This segment, where we take a photo that you send in and point out all the cool things that we can find within the photo. And tonight's a great example of what not to do. Big time warm up across the country. Been hard to get lots of ice over the water. And so this is Meredith Bay in Meredith, New Hampshire. This time of year should be completely frozen with thick ice. Not so much this year. Look at all this open water down here by the dock. And sure, we do have some ice out there, but it's really thin. Notice it lines up right next to that open water, so you know that that's not a substantial thick zone of ice on there on the bay. Also notice that there's some people doing things that we wouldn't advise doing. People are out there on the ice walking along, and you know that this is a problematic area because the fishing house, the ice fishing house, is already sinking into the water.
Not a good idea to go walking out on ice, even if you're trying to rescue the house, when you know it's as thin as this. Mike, back to you.
As we've been joking here on Weather Underground, you've heard of Disney on ice. That's Ditzy on ice. Hey, by the way, you got to stick around because Dave Schwartz is coming up. He's got his Wonders of Weather. Dave always finds some pretty darn amazing stats about today's weather. He's going to share them with you a little bit later in the show. Let's sound off now and answer your questions with Dr. Greg Forbes, with our winter weather expert Tom Nizzle, and Ryan Davidson. Wait, so technically we call you our social meteorologist, but I know you personally.
Oh,
and I feel like you're more, I don't know if this you're more the anti-social meteorologist. So I might just go with meteorologist.
I'm totally
Are you okay
fine
with that?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. But I share your curmudgeoniness.
Thank you.
And
okay.
I'm the king of curmudgeon.
You also then saved me from being curmudgeon and calling you on your curmudgeoniness.
I'm the king of grump. So.
Okay, so the first question we have tonight.
Is?
This one comes from Hugo.
You did that very socially, by the way.
Thank you.
Yes. Hugo, thank you. Please explain the wet bulb, and could it snow with the wet bulb above 32?
Well, it certainly could snow with a wet bulb above 32 because the snow forms higher in the atmosphere. And we get a little melting when we come down, but the temperature itself and the wet bulb could be well above 32, as high as 36, 37 degrees, and the snow is still going to appear as it gets down to the surface. And the wet bulb is the temperature that if you condensed all of the moisture out of the air into a form of liquid water, that's what you would get down to. Your temperature and dew point eventually work their way down to the wet bulb.
All right, thank you, Tom. All right, let's get another question.
All right, the next one is from Dustin.
Dustin, thank you. Is there supposed to be any severe weather in or around Henderson, Kentucky for the next few weeks, or is it all good for that area?
Well, that's certainly the question that, if you've heard the previous segment about our computer models bouncing around, there could be some chance even as early as Tuesday or maybe Wednesday for Henderson, Kentucky. But if some of the models are correct and it pushes the low to the south, then you might get snow instead of severe
right.
weather. But yeah, it certainly seems, if not this next system, probably one after that will give a chance. You can see there that I have for Wednesday, given severe weather for western parts of Kentucky.
In a lot of instances, if you get a big cold front that sweeps through, it's not unheard of to get severe weather one day and maybe snow on the backside on the next.
Yeah.
That's happened in Kentucky more than once.
Yeah.
Thanks for your question tonight.
All right, the next one is from Kimberly.
All right, Kimber Lindemann. Could I be snowed in at a meeting in Battle Creek? Could I be snowed in at a meeting in Battle Creek, Michigan, the weekend of March 5th?
The weekend of March, so that's going to be the end of next week. There may be another system that is going through there latter part of the weekend. Timing's still way in advance. The odds of actually getting snowed in are very low. Mm-hmm. So, but you're going to be in Battle Creek, Michigan. I don't know where you're coming from, but if you're not used to the north, make sure you have winter clothing because the odds are not zero.
If you get snowed in, though, the good news about Battle Creek is they've got all the Kellogg cereal you could possibly want.
Yeah,
so you're going to go. You're not going to go unfed. Trust
That's
us
it.
On this one.
Giddy up.
Thank you all for your questions and keep sending them. And don't forget, we can answer them on the show if you use the hashtag WUTV on Twitter. Excuse me. All right, now the transformation of Coors Field is nearly complete. All right, the hockey rink is being erected in the middle of Denver's baseball stadium. Okay, it is the Stadium Series. The Avalanche will be hosting the Red Wings Saturday night. The question is, will Denver's weather cooperate? Both of these teams, by the way, are really battling for a wild card spot right now. Wait until you see the forecast for Denver. Look at this. 8 o'clock temperature, it's going to be almost 60 degrees in Denver. Highs that afternoon could be in the 70s, by the way. Temperatures are going to stay very warm through the game. I really think for the game, if you're attending, all you need is a light jacket. That's it. Fantastic forecast here for all the fans. I'm not sure it's going to bode well for the ice, though. Let's take you to the Quick Trip 500 Atlanta Motor Speedway as we continue our weather in play. Sunday, the flag drops at 1 o'clock. Look at the temperatures in the 60s. Really comfortable and a lot of sunshine, so no issues for you here at Atlanta Motor Speedway. So, you know, they used to have that race later in the year, and they've actually battled snow at some points. They moved it up, and look at that, warm and sunny. Then we take you to the PGA Honda Classic, Palm Beach Gardens in Florida. Really nice for the first round today. Tomorrow's second round looks spectacular. And for Saturday and the final round on Sunday, temperatures in the 70s, very light wind. Wind should not be an issue at all. But if you're out there and you're in attendance, take the sunscreen. You will definitely use it. Now off to Charleston, West Virginia. Let's take a look at the conditions for you right now. We've been dealing with a little bit of snow in West Virginia this evening. Be careful on the roadways. There could be some icy spots out there. Any roadway that's still a little wet and then maybe freezes over tonight, you could have some poor conditions for travel. Let's get you an update now on your forecast and your weather right now with Keith Carson.
All right, thank you, Mike. Let's take a look at what's going on across the country. Of course, our big story is still that warm storm as it continues to move off to the north and east. Some snow behind it. Still some rain. There's still a warm sector in here in through Boston. Temperatures there still very mild for this time of the year. Ryan, you're killing me with this. All right, well,
it's not me.
We're trying to show you a future forecast here, and what we're going to show you is that temperatures are going to be cooling down. The warm sector, a distant memory. There goes the storm after that, and actually relatively quiet here through most of the day once we get the snow showers out of here tonight. You'll notice some cloudiness here, maybe a little lake effect stuff. Nothing too huge, though. Relatively cold air certainly going over the lakes there. Meanwhile, down across the southeast, not a whole lot going on, so high pressure builds in now behind this storm. And as is the case with a lot of severe weather events, after it, the days after it are pretty calm, pretty stable. Temperatures, though, will be cooler in the 30s overnight as opposed to we had been in the 60s over the past few days prior to the severe weather. And that's kind of how we'll be. And then here we are across parts of the Midwest. Temperatures around average, 33 in Chicago, 31 in Green Bay. The story for them looking forward is that we're going to see a lot of clippers here over the next week. Some of them will be to the north up into Canada. Some of them will clip northern parts of Michigan, and then the one Tom's talking about could be a more major factor as it moves in out of the Rockies. But we'll watch that. Until then, relatively quiet. Temperatures actually going to warm up a bit here in places like Chicago as we look into the weekend. Tomorrow looks about average, but as we head into Saturday, could be near 50 degrees in Chicago. It's a relatively short-lived warm-up, but that's how it goes in February. Meanwhile, down across the southern plains, still some warm air here down across southern Texas. Temperatures in the upper 60s, even some low 70s there. They're on the influence of high pressure as well. So again, it remains quiet until early next week when we start to watch the chance of a storm there. Overnight lows will be in the 40s in Dallas, Houston, and Shreveport coming in the upper 30s. Take a look at that cloud cover. Not much of anything. So it will be nice during the daytime. Overnight lows, though, of course, will get a little bit cooler as a result of that. So high pressure kind of dominating here as we look into the weekend. Pretty nice. 58 in Atlanta, 73 in Miami, 44 in New York. That's what I was talking about in Chicago. 54 in Chicago. Bismarck having a little fun at 64, but a quiet weather day. Not sure what we're going to talk about there on Saturday. Probably the storm on Monday and Tuesday. Here's Sunday with a clipper coming through again, Chicago around 60 degrees. So, Mike, you know how this goes. A lot of times you have some big storms, severe weather. You get a little bit of a timeout after that. So,
we need
that.
It.
Yeah.
Because we know we set ourselves up for another round next week.
It won't last, yeah.
Yeah, so Keith, thank you very much. We're going to get you more of your forecast coming up in a little bit. But we know that Winter Storm Petros still dealing us a little bit of snow. How about a live look tonight? Cleveland on the left side of your screen. That's Pittsburgh on the right side. Both places have had some snow today. Both places are going to get some more snow tonight. Petros just doesn't want to give up. So let's talk about this in detail with our winter weather expert, Tom Nizzle. For a lot of folks, wasn't a great drive this morning, not a great drive home this evening.
No, you're going to have to watch it in this area. And I'll tell you, Petros packed a punch. How do you like that? PPP.
Nice.
The combination of wind and snow in the area that I was really concerned about, right in here, just to the south of Chicago here at the south end of Lake Michigan, Gary Regional Airport last night, while heavy snow was coming down, gusted to 67 miles an hour. They picked up 17 inches of snow in LaPorte. So this system was really a powerful storm. It's moving pretty rapidly now off to the northeast. And as it does so, you know, we're talking about the snow that is still coming down here. Now, we're not going to get several inches out of this, probably 2-3 inches as it goes across upstate New York. The higher elevations of the Appalachians are going to see more snowfall. But my concern always in these is driving, especially along interstates at night. It's wide open. There's nothing going on. And you get into one of these little squalls that comes through, coats the road quickly, and then you can get into really rough driving conditions. So be aware of that.
You mentioned the winds yesterday. not as bad today, right?
No, we're still getting some gusts over 30 miles an hour in some places here. They're used to that in the northern portion and northeastern portion of the U.S. here. So I don't anticipate anything that's going to cause any real big consequences here. But one of the things that is happening is the Appalachians here. It's just interesting. When you get northwesterly flow like this coming down, the Appalachians sit right here. That air comes up over the Appalachian, gets a little bit of lift, and it's just going to squeeze out the rest of the moisture here. So for places like Snowshoe, guess what? Mm-hmm. You're going to be happy because you're going to get much-needed snowfall for skiing.
Maybe nice long weekend if folks want to. They had given an excuse from Tom Nizzle that you could actually go skiing for 3 days.
I'll sign it for you. Yeah.
You need to start that. That'd be a good business.
Temperatures rebounding pretty quickly into the weekend, but for skiing, you should still be okay.
But we're going to get a big rebound in temperatures, yeah. So some of this may compact and melt as we go late weekend, early next week.
Yes, but the higher elevations here, at least we're going to get a few more days of skiing out of this.
All right, Tom, thank you for that very much. Well, an EF2 tornado hitting Lancaster County, Pennsylvania overnight, up to 50 buildings damaged, including an Amish schoolhouse and a chicken barn. They were both leveled. The tornado brought winds up to 125 miles per hour. This is the first confirmed tornado in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania in the winter. In the records, they go back to 1950, right? Incredible images we know over the last 2 days of deadly and destructive tornadoes. The stories of survival, though, are just as incredible.
It's only February, but back-to-back days of deadly tornadoes leave communities in ruin.
Unbelievable. I mean, unbelievable.
In Waverly, Virginia, an EF1 tornado killed two men and a two-year-old child, all found about 300 yards from their mobile home.
This just kind of took our breath away when we got on scene and saw the devastation.
A third death in South Carolina when a man was hit by a falling tree. And in North Carolina, tornado sirens rang out on the campuses of both Duke and UNC as students took cover.
Holy crap, man!
Meanwhile, the Gulf Coast still reeling after at least 28 tornadoes Tuesday. In Louisiana, ongoing cleanup after a preliminary EF2 tornado tore through an RV park, killing two.
The glass was breaking. You could hear things flipping around outside. I mean, just total carnage.
And daylight revealed the scope of the damage near Pensacola, Florida, after an EF3 tornado hit after dark.
And then I watched her, like, literally the baby doing like this.
She was, like, flying out the window, literally. I had her by her ankles.
Some pretty amazing stories of survival, that's for sure. We're joined now by severe weather expert Dr. Greg Forbes, looking back on the last 2 days of violent weather. Very few states, in fact, no states across the South were spared by this, Dr. Forbes. Your latest preliminary count is at 52. You have a feeling that number could go up.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's going to go up because that number was before the end of the day when a lot of the damage survey teams that have been out today from yesterday's tornadoes will be sending in their results. So
52 tornadoes. Where's that rank for a winter outbreak, for a February outbreak?
That's really high. I think it's maybe number three. We had the Super Tuesday 2008 outbreak that had 85 tornadoes. I think there was one in 2012 that maybe had 56, so we might get up into the second place.
How are we doing for tornadoes so far this year, according to averages, or where we've been in to previous years?
Well, January was pretty quiet, but now we've gotten very, very active. We're getting close to three times the average for February, and we've gone 40 to 50% above for the year as a whole. So it's getting pretty active.
All right. So we saw how many issues we had. We've had a couple of outbreaks so far just in February alone. We had the most recent one. We had one about 8 days or so ago. But there's all the states across the South. South Carolina kind of sticks out like a sore thumb, but not a surprise to you that Dixie Alley was lighting up this week.
No, not at all. In nine states there we know have had tornadoes, and Dixie Alley lit up. The issue of Virginia, how far north into Virginia and Pennsylvania that got tornadoes, that was a bit of a surprise, I think, to everyone.
When you look at how violent this was and what has happened since, you know, the beginning of February, do you think we've now gone into the spring season already?
Yeah, it definitely looks like spring is going to set in with a jet stream active, and these warm-ups will give us a chance for severe weather.
All right, Dr. Forbes, thank you for that. And you've got to stick around, by the way, coming up here on Weather Underground. Dr. Forbes is going to show you how to analyze Doppler radar like a boss. Reflectivity, storm relative velocity, correlation coefficient, what do they mean? How do you spot them on a radar screen? You're going to learn from the master himself when we come back right here on Weather Underground.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
I take pictures of sunrises, but with my back pain, I couldn't sleep and get up in time. Then I found Aleve PM.
Aleve PM is the only one to combine a safe sleep aid plus the 12-hour pain-relieving strength of Aleve.
I'm back.
Aleve PM for a better AM.
I'm only in my 60s. I've got a nice long life ahead. Big plans. So when I found out Medicare doesn't pay all my medical expenses, I looked at my options. Then I got a Medicare supplement insurance plan.
If you're eligible for Medicare, you may know it only covers about 80% of your Part B medical expenses. The rest is up to you. Call now and find out about an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like all standardized Medicare Supplement Insurance Plans, it helps pick up some of what Medicare doesn't pay and could save you in out-of-pocket medical costs.
To me, relationships matter. I've been with my doctor for 12 years. Now I know I'll be able to stick with them.
With these types of plans, you'll be able to visit any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients. Plus, there are no networks and virtually no referrals needed. So don't wait. Call now and request this free decision guide to help you better understand Medicare and which AARP Medicare supplement plan might be best for you. There's a wide range to choose from.
We love to travel, and there's so much more to see. So we found a plan that can travel with us anywhere in the country.
Join the millions of people who have already enrolled in the only Medicare Supplement Insurance plans endorsed by AARP, an organization serving the needs of people 50 and over for generations. Remember, all Medicare Supplement Insurance plans help cover what Medicare doesn't pay and could save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. Call now to request your free decision guide and learn more about the kinds of plans that will be here for you now and down the road.
I have a lifetime of experience, so I know how important that is.
The all-new Lexus RX and RX Hybrid. Agile handling, available 12.3-inch navigation screen, and panorama glass roof. Never has luxury been this expressive. This is the pursuit of perfection.
You know what makes me a weather geek is owning like 5 weather stations at my house, and then I name them. Who does that? Seriously. I did. I named my weather station Albedo.
For you weather geeks, you'll understand what that is.
And then I have Albedo Jr. Don't ask. Join the Weather Channel fan community at weloveweather.tv.
Tomorrow on AMHQ, it's a welcome weekend warm-up, but it could cause some problems for the NHL's Outdoor Stadium Series in Denver. We hit the ice tomorrow, starting at 5, right here on AMHQ.
This is what is meant by a rotational couplet, where you've got wind that is moving away from the radar and going toward the radar.
Ah, good news there. You saw just briefly a little flash of yellows and greens. Now the newest scan has come in and the rotation seems to weaken.
And it does look like there is evidence of debris. So I think we've probably got a tornado ongoing.
See if we have any debris signature left. Maybe it's left some of the debris behind, tossed it up in the air and it's falling out.
We're able to actually see that there is debris being wafted into the air that coincides very well with the circulation in this case.
That was some serious radar analysis from Carl Parker, Dr. Greg Forbes over the last couple of days. You heard some things in there, some couplets and debris signatures and velocities. How can you be a radar guru like those guys? We're going to help you out, by the way. Dr. Forbes is here to walk you through the different things that you actually look for yourself when you're looking for a tornado on radar, Dr. Forbes.
And the one thing is, if you have a supercell thunderstorm that is rotating, sometimes it will be the one that will have the biggest and the most tornadoes, the most dangerous tornadoes, and that whole pattern then will wrap itself around into a hook echo. And you can see the hook echo showing up in there. And then right down at the end of the hook, that's where the tornado likes to be. I sometimes call those debris balls. The inflow notch here, where you don't have much precipitation, that's where the warm air is flowing into the thunderstorm, and then it rises up. Now, we also have then Doppler radars, and so you can see the winds going counterclockwise there in that red and blue couplet, and that's where the two directions touch is what we call a tornado vortex signature. There you have the biggest shift of the winds. Farther out, you have the rotation around the thunderstorm, the wall cloud. Now, right underneath the area, if there's a tornado in progress, we can have a debris being tossed up into the air, and it can tumble around. And in the form of a dual pole radar, that would show up as a blue a circle here, surrounded by red for precipitation. So that's what we call a tornado debris signature when you hear us talking on air.
All right, so if you look for the velocities, you look for the debris signature, and then you look for the correlation where they're together.
Yeah.
A lot of times the National Weather Service will say this is a confirmed tornado by radar. Yeah. If you had the velocities, but you didn't necessarily see this blue and maybe it was just red, does that necessarily mean you didn't have a tornado?
Well, it doesn't mean you didn't, but often the radar is 4, 5, sometimes 8,000 feet above ground where its beam is, and so that could be the rotation up in the cloud rather than down in the ground. But when you see this dual pole signature, the debris signature, that means there is a tornado in progress tossing up debris.
So you can see it in real time on the radar, but then afterwards, once the damage is done, weather service teams will go out and assess the damage. Dr. Forbes, you've done this many, many times. This is a look in Pennsylvania at some of the damage we've had here, and this was rated an EF2 tornado.
Yeah, it really was. What the whole structure here that was destroyed and tossed up through the field, you can see it going out through the trees. It's the little specks in there are parts of the debris from that, and then you could see the converging of some of the tree
ground fall. Scour through the field as well.
Ground scour, I think I saw there some suction swaths in some of the corn stubble, and here's what is left, and here's where the structure came to rest.
So there's a before with forecast, the during when you're looking at the radar, and the after when you're doing the storm survey.
Yeah, you have to look at the damage to assess how intense the tornado was.
All right, Dr. Forbes, thank you. Let's head over to our weather cave now and check in with Ryan.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, coming up next, we're going to be talking to you and answering your questions. So tweet us now, use hashtag WUTV, and we'll start answering your questions. Some of them pretty good. You like this one from Martin? Is there any way to tell how strong a tornado really is on radar? As a matter of fact, maybe there could be. Dr. Forbes will answer that next. Mike?
All right, thanks, Ryan. Time to test your Weather Underground IQ now. What temperature is considered absolute zero? Is it 0 degrees, minus 212, or minus 460 degrees? Think about it. The answer is coming up after this short break.
Here in the city, parking is hard to find. Seems like everyone drives. And those who do should switch to GEICO because you could save hundreds on car insurance. Oh, perfect. Valet parking. Hello.
Evening, sir.
Here's the keys. And go easy on the right, mate. Wouldn't mind some of that beef Wellington.
To see how much you could save on car insurance, go to GEICO.com.
Lose weight fast with Slim Fast Advanced Snacks. New peanut butter chocolate bites and sour cream and onion chips. Great tasting 100 calorie snacks packed with protein and fiber. Slim Fast Advanced Snacks. It's your thing.
Building the only trucks with the best fuel economy. Best towing. Best torque. And best payload. Takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle, that's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to 2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
You know what made me really love weather was growing up in Ohio and getting a lot of snow in the wintertime. And my dad used to get so excited when it snowed because he'd take me and my sister sledding. And to me, it was one of my fondest childhood memories, winter sledding with my sister and my dad.
Cough tires you and everyone around. During a cold, excess phlegm can build up in your lungs and keep you coughing. To stop cough, you have to get the excess phlegm out. Tocol is a powerful multi-symptom cold syrup that helps eject phlegm. Tocol's triple action quiets cough, clears airways, and gets rid of phlegm with a productive cough that relieves you. For phlegm and cough relief, this is my guarantee or your money back. Tocol, the phlegm ejector at Walgreens.
Is it asking too much for a sofa to last long enough to go out of style? Or to expect your kids' bedroom furniture to survive childhood? At City Furniture, we don't think so. Everything we sell is built to build a life around. Find the right look for your life at cityfurniture.com.
Tomorrow on AMHQ, it's a welcome weekend warm-up, but it could cause some problems for the NHL's Outdoor Stadium Series in Denver. We hit the ice tomorrow, starting at 5, right here on AMHQ.
Currently in our area, 62 degrees under clear skies. Tonight, mainly clear skies. Low 49. Winds northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Friday, a mainly sunny sky. High 71. Winds northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Friday night, clear skies. Low 49. Winds north-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Before the break, we tested your Woo IQ. The question, what temperature is considered absolute zero? Zero, minus 212, or minus 460? The answer? Minus 460 degrees. It is amazing out there. We know that your stunning weather photos prove it each and every day. We don't need much explanation for this sunset over New York. That is the Manhattan Bridge, and that is a wonderful HDR photo. That is truly fantastic. Look at that one all night. Well, let's get personal with the weather tonight, and let's join from Beverly Shores, Indiana, personal weather station user Greg Brown tonight. Greg, good to talk to you tonight. Let's talk about the pretty decent snow and storm that you just had. What kind of conditions did you end up reporting where you were?
You know, we had started at 4 a.m. on Wednesday. We had 20 to 25 mile an hour winds. And then at noon, they increased to 35 to 40, and they were sustained there for a while. And then 4 to 6 p.m. last night, they were constant at 45. We had gusts up over 60.
Gusts over 60 miles an hour? Are you kidding me? How long have you had your weather station? Have you ever seen winds like that on your weather station before?
I had one in October of 2011. It was 80 miles an hour.
Are you in a very exposed area here? How close are you to the lake?
I'm 300 feet from the water.
Oh, well, okay. That would explain it then. As far as the snow goes, how much did you pick up?
We had only about 6 inches here because the snow blows right over top of us with all the winds that we had.
Maybe just a little bit too close to the lake in that regard. Is that typically what happens, that you end up getting, you know, areas more inland get heavier snow than you do?
Right. The lake effect starts about a mile in back of us.
But I imagine, Greg, the summers are pretty delightful there.
They are. That's why we live here.
Hey, Greg, appreciate you talking to us this evening. Sounds like you went through a pretty good snowstorm there for sure. The winds for sure.
We did. Thank you.
All right. Hey, appreciate it. Good talk to you tonight. And if you're a weather station owner and you report to Weather Underground, you want to be on the show with us, just send us an email, WUTV@wonderground.com. Give us your location, your personal weather station ID, and we will take it from there. All right. Let's answer some of your questions tonight. We know you have a lot of them. Most of the questions seems tonight have been about next week's storm, Ryan.
We have very astute followers.
We do.
They're like, okay, your severe weather event is over.
They're over it, right?
What are we looking at
Let's
next?
Let's look forward. It's good to be looking forward, though. Who are we starting with?
First one is coming from Martin.
All right, Martin, thanks for your question tonight. Is there any way to tell how strong a tornado really is on radar?
Well, with the kind of National Weather Service radar, often the tornado can be 50, 60, 100 miles away. So it's a little bit difficult to really get the velocity of the tornado on that one. On the other hand, there are research teams that have mobile Doppler radars, and they can get within a mile or two of the tornado. And so they can get pretty realistic values of the velocities of the rotation, even right in the tornado.
Well, those mobile Dopplers are fascinating technology, aren't they? Give you an incredible view of a tornado. All right, next.
Okay, the next one.
You say that with a pause.
I'm loading more, so okay. I can't see them. It's with Brandon.
Brandon, thank you. How does lake effect snow work after the low front leaves? Does another low pressure form?
A full low pressure system doesn't form. The pressure drops over the lake because of the warm air. It's more buoyant. But lake effect really occurs. It can occur under a high pressure system. All you're doing is moving cold air across warm, moist water. That warm, moist water produces moisture into the air. And because it's buoyant, there's your lift. You eventually condense that out into the form of snow, and the winds position it downstream on shore. So all that can be done without a low pressure system.
All right, thank you. Good question tonight. All right, next one.
All right, last one's from Eric.
Eric, thank you. Is there a correlation between a mild winter and a cool, hot summer? That's a tough question.
My recollection is that those sort of six-month correlations, lag correlations, as we call them, are not very high in general. So mostly not.
Not a lot of skill on that.
Yeah. Thank you very much for your questions this evening. We'll keep answering them throughout the show. I keep using the hashtag WUTV on Twitter. By the way, voting over right now for a best video of the day. So the question is, which one will it be? Storm time lapse or Louisiana tornado? We reveal the results in a matter of minutes. And up next, we're going old school.
Oh.
Dave Schwartz. We didn't call you old, Dave. You're young at heart. He's got his wonders of weather. He's got his chalkboard. By the way, Dave's a Southpaw.
I am.
Did you know that?
Yeah.
He goes left all the way, right? He's the Philadelphia kid. Dave's got his great weather stats when we come back on Weather Underground.
I'm looking dapper there, too.
Wow. Get the vest on.
Yeah. Okay.
Don't miss Founders Days at Pep Boys. Buy two Rain-X Latitude water repellency wiper blades and get $10 off instantly. And when you buy three select tires, you get the fourth free instantly. Trust the boys to get you there.
So there's a family wedding coming up in New Mexico, but a nice hotel can be pricey. If you visit Priceline, get a great deal and go.
Hi, Amanda. Want you to meet your second cousin, Tim. He's moving out your way in a couple of months.
Cool. So I guess your mom and my mom...
All I know is we're related.
Yeah.
If you don't go...
I'm Tim.
Amanda.
Whatever's on the line. Priceline.
Let me talk to you about retirement.
A 401k is the most sound way to go. Let's talk asset allocation.
Sure.
You seem knowledgeable, professional.
Would you trust me as your financial advisor?
I would.
I would indeed.
Well, let's be clear here. I'm actually a DJ.
No way.
I have no financial experience at all.
That really is you.
If they're not a CFP pro, you just don't know. Find a certified financial planner professional who's thoroughly vetted at letsmakeaplan.org. CFP, work with the highest standard.
Watch. Nothing can stop Crizal No Glare lenses. Neither water, nor smudge, nor scratch, nor damaging UV rays, nor glare of night can keep you from the clearest vision possible. Ask for Crizal No Glare lenses and live life in the clear. Essilor, the makers of Crizal, Verilux, and Transitions lenses. Better sight, better life.
IBSD. You know the symptoms when they start. Abdominal pain, urgent diarrhea. Now there's prescription Xifaxan. Xifaxan is a new IBSD treatment that helps relieve your diarrhea and abdominal pain symptoms. And Xifaxan works differently. It's a prescription antibiotic that acts mainly in the digestive tract. Do not use Xifaxan if you have a history of sensitivity to rifaximin, rifamycin antibiotic agents, or any components of Xifaxan. Tell your doctor right away if your diarrhea worsens while taking Xifaxan, as this may be a sign of a serious or even fatal condition. Tell your doctor if you have liver disease or are taking other medications, because these may increase the amount of Xifaxan in your body. Tell your doctor if you are pregnant, plan on becoming pregnant, or are nursing. The most common side effects are nausea and an increase in liver enzymes. If you think you have IBS with diarrhea, talk to your doctor about new Xifaxan.
When you report the weather,
oh yes, yes, yes,
there are two things you can never forget: a sense of adventure and a warm jacket.
Yes!
L.L. Bean, official outfitter of the Weather Channel.
Listen to that!
I can get over 60 sheets of drywall into my Mercedes-Benz mattress.
To get 60 sheets of drywall into my small van, I invented the Fold-O-Matic 5000.
My mattress also holds over 2,500 pounds of payload.
Hauling 2,500 pounds in my small van is no problem. I just divide and conquer.
Hauls more, stows more, tows more, and fits in your garage. The midsize mattress from Mercedes-Benz. Vans, born to run.
Her mind erased, her body tattooed, and she did it all to herself.
This is all your plan. It's time to get started.
These cases keep getting more dangerous.
They're scared of you, and they should be.
Blindspot returns Monday after The Voice on NBC.
Closed captioning brought to you by California Walnuts.
What makes this the best simple dinner ever? Great tasting, heart healthy California walnuts. So simple. Get the recipes at walnuts.org.
All right, folks, welcome back to Weather Underground. It's time for Rapid Weather. Our three biggest weather stories of the day, 30 seconds each. Who wants to go first? Tom Nizzle?
No,
yeah,
you.
Me?
All right, babe, all right, why not?
I'll do it. I'll do it. Let's go warm weather. Saturday into Sunday, we got warm air with the jet stream going well to the north. That means temperatures 25 to 30 degrees above average. For some of you, temperatures could soar into the 70s this weekend. How about your forecast from Kansas City to Goodland, Rapid City to Bismarck? Scorching hot. Let's take a look at some of the numbers across the south. 74 in San Antonio, 72 in Shreveport. We'll do 72 in Oklahoma City. How about the forecast on Sunday? Almost 80 in San Antonio, 72 in Little Rock is 12 degrees above average. And the forecast across the north is going to be just as pleasant. Enjoy the warmth this weekend. I'm out. Tom Nizzle, you're in. Take it over, bud.
Well, I'll tell you what, Winter Storm Petros produced a tremendous variety of winter weather across the Great Lakes region northeast, and I think we're going to have this coming up now. Take a look here. LaPorte, Indiana, 17 inches of snow, winds gusting over 60 miles an hour during this storm. Not much left of this storm right now. As we go into the future here, we're going to see that as we get into next week, we're going to bring the next storm system in, and that storm system, some of the computer models forecasting another big snow event going from Chicago up across the upper Great Lakes, some a little further south into the Ohio Valley. Greg?
And we're going to have another episode of severe weather coming up Tuesday and Wednesday for sure. Our computer models are bouncing around a little bit, but it looks as if we'll have on Tuesday some severe weather across parts of Central East Texas, Oklahoma, maybe over into the Missouri to Louisiana area, probably overnight over into the Mississippi Valley area. Could be some tornadoes as well. Three for Southeast Texas, up closer to the surface low in Northeast Texas, a Torcon of four, and fours all the way across the rest of that area. Then the next day, severe thunderstorms maybe all the way to Atlanta.
All right. Thank you very much, Dr. Forbes. Let's take you on a tour of the country and take a look this evening at Syracuse, New York. We've had a few flakes of flying out there. You can see the roads are wet, but a little dusting on the cars that are parked there. Maybe you're having a little dinner this evening. Hey, enjoy. Just watch the snow out the window as you have a great big giant bowl of French onion soup. Hello to you in St. Louis. Let's look over the mighty Mississippi. Nice evening for you in St. Louis. The forecast gets pretty warm here. St. Louis, Kansas City, Tulsa, Oklahoma. You're gonna enjoy temperatures maybe 15, 20 degrees above average in the coming days. Now we take you to Phoenix, Arizona. We'll look over the Valley of the Sun. Not a cloud in the sky. Crystal clear out there, and visibility's pretty good, so it doesn't look like haze is all that much of an issue for us this evening. Last stop, Los Angeles. Forecast here is also pretty darn nice. I gotta say, not a lot of haze in LA either, so maybe no inversion is set up for us here despite those beautiful blue skies overhead. Let's get an update on your forecast now. Check in with Keith Carson and your weather right now.
Surprisingly good air quality there in LA. All right, let's talk about what's going on across the Northeast. Still some rain here down the 495 corridor. Had some nasty thunderstorms early this morning across New England. That doesn't happen too often in February. Some snow on the backside as well. Temperatures in the 20s, 29 in Pittsburgh, 34 in Burlington, Vermont. Look at that, Bangor sitting at 43, 47 in Boston. It's been kind of a quiet winter there, and that's how it looks like it'll stay for the foreseeable future. We get these snow showers out of here by tomorrow morning. It's chilly, though. Look at Burlington and Bangor at that point, 12 and 11, respectively. We get a little sunshine, even with the sun, though. Temperatures only into the 20s, 30s, 36 in New York. Down across the southeast, big ridge of high pressure. Temperatures one day after another slowly start increasing. So a lot of sunshine, still on the cool side at first on Friday. But it looks great this weekend. We'll have another look at the Northeast, Southeast, and we'll throw in the Midwest and the Plains in just about 30 minutes. Guys?
All right. Nothing is left untouched. Thank you very much, Keith. Time to wow you with Dave Schwartz and his wonders of weather. Dave Schwartz, you said that you're going to try tonight to compare and contrast East versus West.
Yeah. You know, we've had all the severe weather, Texas all the way up to Virginia. The wind, the coal back here in the Midwest. But what hasn't been getting a lot of press is all the water that's been falling. You know, we had this low just move right up in here. The low is somewhere in there. It's got occluded from the front, which is offshore. But between the low here and the high here, we're really getting cold air driving southward. Yeah. Would you believe if Frenchville, Maine is the northernmost reporting site we have in the East Coast.
Okay.
Frenchville, right?
Frenchville.
Way up here. 46 degrees
that
right
now. That seems pretty mild.
That's mild when you consider that Atlanta's 45.
Oh, well.
They've got
take
a beat.
Me to Frenchville, Dave.
Hello. And we got northwest winds in here. Frenchville will cool down tomorrow. Yeah. But just for the time, with all that warm air coming northward, in addition to the storms, we had very heavy rain. I mean, 1 to 2.5 inches.
Yeah, it poured.
In parts of the Northeast last night where there was still snow on the ground. So we had snow melting and running off. We had water coming down. We've got an ice jam going on here in upstate New York. That happens once, you know, the river freezes over. Then it warms up and the ice starts breaking up.
Seems like this is more like a mid-March.
Right, right. It's usually a spring kind of.
Weeks from now.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you get these warm surges, if you get the ice to break up, chunks of ice pile up at bridges and pilings, forming a dam, and then the backwater coming in behind it overflows onto roads. That's the issue on Route 29 here in Herkimer County.
Gotcha.
So, yeah, you're right. Well, we're not used to that this time of year, but it's happening. The Housatonic River in Connecticut is flooding at Stevenson Dam, flooded streams in Sussex County, New Jersey. So a lot happening here because of the warmth and the rain that we picked up. By contrast, look at the West, Mike.
So
unbelievable.
Dry,
unbelievable.
So
you talk about non El Nino, right? We're high and dry. 61 in Seattle right now. 66 in Kelso, Washington, just down the road from Portland. Roseburg at 72. Our average high's in the mid-50s. San Jose, 77. You know, that's great, but we need rain.
We do.
Look at Riverside, RAL, 85 degrees. The hot spot in the country right now.
It's usually a hot spot.
Right.
Yeah.
Since October, we've had 4 inches of rain. Since October 1st. This is the wet season. Our average is 8.2, and so far this month, we would be averaging that much rain. That's a lot of rain.
2.45.
You know how
inches.
Much we've gotten so far?
Let me
far?
Guess, like zero or
0.24.
That's
exactly
it.
1/10 Jeez. Of the average.
That's pathetic.
So yeah, it's beautiful outside. No inversion over LA, but I think we'd trade in some of this heat.
Yeah, and water restrictions still in place for California. They're trying to conserve 25% of their water.
Absolutely. So wow in the East means we're overwatered. Here in the West, where's our water? We need it. Let's keep our fingers crossed.
Dave's wonders of weather.
I'm out of here.
I'll go with you, Dave.
All right, let's go.
Let's hand it over to Keith Carson and your video six pack.
All right, informative as always. Thank you, Dave. Let's start, as we should, with number six. In Illinois, about 30 miles to the south of Chicago, they had a power pole crack over here. And as a result, it caught fire. And I didn't know this happened very often, but Mike and I were discussing, we've seen a couple of videos like this over the past few weeks. So apparently that's what happens when it hits the snow there. Number five, double rainbow at Penn State College yesterday. Always a nice look there. Wild weather in Pennsylvania. They went from severe weather all the way to some snow after that. So a little bit of everything there. Number four, time-lapse of heavy rain hitting uptown Charlotte yesterday. Uptown, by the way, apparently is what locals call the city center. Billy Joel comes to mind.
I'm not gonna sing it. Uptown funk.
Yeah, all right, a little more modern take of it there. Yeah. I'm still thinking Billy Joel, but anyways, there's the rain moving through. They had some strong winds, but no tornadoes, tornado warnings there. All right, let's go to number three here, and it's a tornado in Louisiana. Now watch this. Look at the wind direction there, right to left, right? And then, as the tornado approaches, whoop, other direction. I actually think that could have been a number one video. That was pretty cool, the way it shifted around as it went over the highway.
And, I agree. Totally
but
agree.
We don't have a choice in these matters. We're mere pawns. Let's look at one and two and see where the votes ended up.
All right. It ended up with a time-lapse versus tornado, and the results were...
Okay, it's close. Louisiana tornado. So we're going
to... It's hard to beat a tornado.
It is. Let's start with the time-lapse. This is in Raleigh-Durham yesterday. And taken from a hotel... Up there.
See the shelf cloud there, rain shaft comes on through.
That one's
pretty
cool.
Pretty solid.
I'm always afraid to take a video from a hotel window because you can see a reflection. Anyways, let's do number one, tornado in Louisiana, which we were unsure whether or not it was a tornado at first. There was some debate about it, but there we go.
It looks like a big tornado.
Yeah. It does. You know what? Looking at it now, it does. When I saw it in a little monitor, it looked like a rain shaft. But this is a big tornado.
Bigger's better.
Yeah.
In this case. All right. Thank you for that very much, Keith. And still to come here, breaking down deadly storms by the numbers, we're going to show you some of those impressive stats we've seen, including what makes this week's tornado outbreak so unique.
Where can you satisfy your craving for a delicious 100% Alaskan cod meal? Right here at Long John Silver's. Enjoy our tasty two-piece hand-battered Alaskan cod basket, hand-dipped in our classic batter, now for just $5.99. Because at Long John Silver's, you deserve more.
From the moment they wake up, doers don't stop. Every day is a chance to do something great. And for the ones they love, they'd do anything. Sears Optical has glasses made for doing. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
Pet moments are beautiful, unless you have allergies. Then your eyes may see it differently. Only Flonase is approved to relieve both itchy, watery eyes and congestion. No other nasal allergy spray can say that. When we breathe in allergens, our bodies react by overproducing six key inflammatory substances that cause our symptoms. Most allergy pills only control one substance. Flonase controls six, and six is greater than one. Complete allergy relief or incomplete? Let your eyes decide. Flonase, six is greater than one, changes everything.
Even when you're taking an antidepressant, you may still be struggling with depression. You try to put on a brave face, but inside the symptoms linger. In fact, 2 out of 3 people taking an antidepressant may still experience unresolved symptoms. When added to your current antidepressant, Rexulti, brexpiprazole, has been shown to reduce symptoms of depression. It may help you feel better without giving up the progress you may have made with your current antidepressant. Rexulti is not for everyone. Call your doctor about unusual changes in behavior, worsening depression, or thoughts of suicide. Antidepressants can increase these in those 24 and younger. Elderly dementia patients taking Rexulti have an increased risk of death or stroke. Call your doctor if you have high fever, stiff muscles, and confusion to address a possible life-threatening condition, or if you have uncontrollable muscle movements, as these may be permanent. High blood sugar was reported with Rexulti, and in extreme cases can lead to coma or death. Other risks are increased cholesterol, weight gain, decreased white blood cells, which can be serious, dizziness on standing, seizures, trouble swallowing, and impaired judgment or motor skills. Don't give up on the progress you may have made with your current antidepressant. Talk to your doctor about adding Rexulti and feel better about facing the world. You may qualify to get your first 30 days free. Visit Rexulti.com for details.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
Breathe. Come over here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those.
We're
You're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
If you have high blood pressure like I do, many cold medicines may raise your blood pressure. That's why there's Coracetin HBP. It relieves cold symptoms without raising blood pressure. So look for powerful cold medicine with the heart. Coracetin HBP.
We know at least 8 people have died during a 2-day severe weather outbreak across the South and Mid-Atlantic. The preliminary tornado count from Tuesday, Wednesday now, up to around
53, at least.
Dr. Vorts, it's 53 and counting. Pennsylvania and Virginia had their most powerful February tornadoes on record yesterday. We're joined now by our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes. The numbers keep going up second by second here. A little aftermath, if you will, as we break down this outbreak by the numbers. You look at the southern tornadoes, Dr. Forbes, nearly every southern state is hit here, and now we're talking more than 4 dozen tornadoes.
Yeah, absolutely, and some of those were expected there in across Louisiana over into Alabama, Florida, Georgia, southern Georgia got 3 tornadoes, but then North Carolina, Virginia, we expected tornadoes there, but probably not in Pennsylvania with 2 tornadoes and EF2 there.
Let's take it farther north, Dr. Forbes. Some interesting stats about this outbreak. Yeah. We had severe thunderstorm warnings in Maine. First time they've ever issued February thunderstorm warnings at the Portland Weather Service office or the Caribou office.
Yeah, that really is incredible. And the thunderstorms with damaging winds marched all the way. There even were some damaging wind reports in Maine. So very incredible.
Nuts. And then you go down into Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. Our Lancaster County, first ever winter tornado, 125 miles an hour. We had 2 tornadoes in Pennsylvania. We had only previously had 1 February tornado in Pennsylvania since accurate records have been kept. So this was a real shock.
Yeah, it really was. And the second of the tornadoes was up in Bradford County. That's pretty far to the north up in the forest. And they don't get very many tornadoes there at any month of the year.
And let alone February, right? Yeah. Then we had a little bit farther south. We take you down into Virginia. The first tornado-related death in the month of February. Mm-hmm. That, I think, to a lot of people is probably very surprising.
Yeah, it really is. And not just fluke tornadoes either. There were EF3 tornadoes that were really destructive. I was just seeing a 28-mile path for some of the damage survey coming in. So long-lived tornadoes with supercell thunderstorms in February in Virginia, very, very unusual.
Then down into Florida, strongest tornado of the year in Escambia County, 155-mile-an-hour winds. It held the previous. Yeah. It had another EF3 happen 10 or 11 days prior to that,
the mid-February outbreak, it beat that one out by 3 miles per hour. Those were the first 2 EF3s of the year, and now we've had several more.
And then of all the states got hit, except South Carolina. No tornadoes in South Carolina.
Yeah, a lot of the activity started in North Carolina and went north, so they sort of got skipped in the overnight Tuesday night gap.
All right, Dr. Forbes, thank you. That being the aftermath of the tornadoes. Well, when a tornado hits, the dangers of survivors, danger for survivors who ride out these storms at home are often just the beginning. Meteorologist Maria LaRosa takes us through the danger after the tornado has ended.
There's no structure, there's no roof, there's just nothing. It's almost like a dumping ground where you are.
In December, as an EF3 tornado approached Rowlett, Texas, Scott Fleming took shelter in a bathroom. While his safe place was planned out, Scott was unprepared for what followed.
It was dark and I didn't have a flashlight with me. It happened so quick we didn't grab any of that. Here I am in house shoes, stepping over things, feeling your way through. You hope you don't impale yourself with anything.
Everywhere you go, there's going to be dangerous situations. You can get a cut and an infection from nails. You can get electrocuted from wires. You can see that there's glass everywhere, pipes that might have gas in them. These are all the dangers that exist.
Tadagolia, founder of the First Response Team of America, suggests storing essentials like a flashlight, batteries, clothes, and sturdy shoes in your safe place. And once you've left a neighborhood struck by a storm, you shouldn't rush to return.
It's important to give the local officials some time to make sure the electrical lines are shut off, to make sure that the gas is shut off.
Let the trained professionals get in there, assess the situation, control the scene, and then at the appropriate time, they'll let the homeowners back in when needed to be.
And that's why skilled operators from the First Response Team are welcomed by emergency managers in the wake of destructive tornadoes.
When an individual has training, has the safety precautions in mind, and is able to work their unit properly and effectively. Like Tad and his team, we couldn't ask for anything better.
They do some pretty remarkable work. Hey, what'd you learn on the show today? You can tweet us right now using the hashtag #WhatILearned. We could feature your comment right here live on the show. And Death Trap on Wheels, Home Sweet Home, A Bullseye in the Roof. That's tonight's open mic.
Responding by storm, powered by Ram Trucks. Guts, glory, Ram.
Building the only trucks with the best fuel economy. Best towing. Best torque. And best payload. Takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle. That's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to $2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
Growing up, we were German. We danced in a German dance group. I wore Lederhosen. When I first got on Ancestry, I was really surprised that I wasn't finding all of these Germans in my tree. I decided to have my DNA tested through Ancestry DNA. The big surprise was we're not German at all. 52% of my DNA comes from Scotland and Ireland. So I traded in my Lederhosen for a kilt.
Ancestry has many paths to discovering your story. Get started for free at Ancestry.com.
We know you love weekends. We do too. That's why weekend weather is so important.
Talking about this crazy weather, what do you think about this?
Get the most out of your days off by watching AMHQ Weekends.
You've got so much to look at, so much to keep track of.
With Reynolds Wolf, Kelly Cass, and Dr. Greg Postel.
This is a great way to start the day.
Ready to start your weekend with the weather.
Wow, man, look at that. Isn't that cool?
AMHQ Weekends, every weekend starting at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 61 degrees under clear skies. Tonight, mainly clear skies, low 49, winds northwest at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Friday, a mainly Friday night, clear skies, low 49, winds north-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
What you doing?
Just prepping for my boss's party in a couple weeks.
What are those?
Pressed white strips. They whiten way better than paste.
Crisp 3D white strips whiten 25 times better than a leading whitening toothpaste.
I'd say someone's making quite an impression.
Crisp 3D white strips, the way to whiten.
It's just lose weight fast with Slim Fast Advanced Smoothie Mix. Replace a meal with delicious new flavors like creamy chocolate with 20 grams of protein, as low as 1 gram of sugar, and 100% daily fiber. Slim Fast Advanced Smoothies, it's your thing.
How do you know when you've had a successful first date?
You want to go on a second date.
Match leads to more second dates than any other dating app.
I could see myself downloading it.
Jackie joined Match. When will you? Start for free today.
This is Peloton, the indoor cycling experience designed to happen in your home. Only Peloton allows you to take high-energy live and on-demand studio cycling classes without having to go anywhere. Ride live with some of the best studio cycling instructors in the country. Ride flexible with thousands of on-demand rides. Ride connected alongside riders from all around the world. This is fitness evolved. This is Peloton.
You work hard to keep your family safe, and so do we. Xfinity Home provides 24/7 security with professional monitoring for 24/7 peace of mind. Stay connected with real-time text and email alerts. And keep an eye on things from anywhere. Xfinity Home. Connected. Protected. Home. Xfinity customers add Xfinity Home from Comcast for $29.99 a month for 12 months and get 5 additional door and window sensors for no extra charge. Call or go online today.
Stroll through the woods and visit the working sculpture studio of famed artist Gert Olson at the annual open house in Jupiter Farms on Saturday and Sunday, February 27th and 28th. From noon to 5, Gert's works have been shown all over the world, and now is your chance to see it in person. See these unique sculptures, as well as the paintings, pottery, and fine jewelry by these fine artists. Olson Studio is located on 177th Place North in Jupiter Farms. We look forward to seeing you there.
Tomorrow on AMHQ, it's a welcome weekend warm-up, but it could cause some problems for the NHL's Outdoor Stadium Series in Denver. We hit the ice tomorrow, starting at 5, right here on AMHQ.
All right, let's sound off as we wrap up the show and answer some of your questions tonight, whether it be winter weather, whether it be severe weather, whether it be whatever you want to talk about.
Weather.
Yeah, whether it be weather.
Anything. Sky's limit, literally. First one is coming up from Samantha.
All right, Samantha, thanks for your question tonight. When there is a tornado outbreak, why does the storms always move northeast? Is this common?
It is very common. That's the preferred motion. It's because there's usually an upper-level jet stream that's coming in, and the winds in that are from the southwest, and so that just steers the thunderstorms off to the north and east. But sometimes, on occasion, they'll even move northwestern if there's a big closed low and the steering winds go from southeast to northwest.
All right, good question. Appreciate that.
All right, next one's from Sean.
Sean, thanks for your question. I saw a National Weather Service special weather statement Wednesday for a cell moving 100 miles an hour. Is this possible?
I didn't see any 100 mile per hour, but we had quite a few that the storm motion was thought to be 70 miles per hour. 100 miles per hour, that sounds pretty high. I wouldn't rule it out, but that would be really, really extreme.
Have you ever seen that before?
In hurricanes, maybe. Okay. For some of the little cells that are in hurricanes.
By the way, I like the Twitter handle there. Bro Crush 36. Sounds like something Keith Carson like would have.
No, mine is Teddy Roosevelt.
Oh,
Teddy
Roosevelt.
All right, the next one's from Travis.
Travis, thank you. When will Amarillo, Texas see some more snow?
Boy, I don't see a lot of cold air getting down there over the next week or so. I think with the track of this next system, it's going to stay just north of them. So I can't promise anything in the next week and a half.
Yeah, and in the short term, through the weekend, it gets really hot there.
It warms up 70s, very
right?
much, yeah.
All right, we got time for one more question, I think.
Snap, and he's thinking ahead in Louisiana.
All right. Will the warm weather cause any flooding from snow ice melt? Where? I guess it could be anywhere.
He's in Louisiana.
He's in Louisiana. There's nothing in Louisiana.
Up in the northeast, certainly, where there is snow, there's ice jam flooding that is occurring now from the combination of rain and warm temperatures. And we're going to see that over the next week or so up in that area. Not real thick ice up there this winter season, but it is breaking up whenever you get rain and warm temps.
And you had been saying that the ice jams happening now may prevent us from getting any, big spring, typical spring, big spring flooding.
The earlier we can flush that out, the better.
All right. Yep. Thank you, everyone, for your questions. And reminder, if you're new to watching the show, we answer your questions live on the show every day. If you're on Twitter, use the hashtag WUTV. Let's get a final check of your current conditions and your forecast with meteorologist Keith Carson.
All right. Thank you, Mike. Let's take a look at what's going on across the country. Of course, our main story is still that low, that winter storm moving off to the north and east. Some snow behind it, a little bit of rain in the warm sector as well. That's where most of the action is across parts of New England. Staying rain there. Temperatures are staying mild. Back end of this, some snow squalls in there. That's what will continue here during the overnight hours. Eventually, though, kind of fades away. Lake enhancement fades away as well. And the temperatures drop big time. Dave talked earlier about Frenchville, Maine. Way up here where our banner is. How disrespectful. We're going to move that banner. Anyways, it's up here. They're going to be in the teens after being warmer than Atlanta. So it will crash back to reality very quickly. Temperatures in the upper 30s in Boston. All right, here's what we've got going on across the southeast, which is to say, not very much. We got a little topography stuff here, maybe a snow shower or two, but otherwise quiet. Temperatures around 30 to 33 here in some of the major cities down across the southeast. Of course, when this high gets overhead, winds get calm, we're clear, to a lot of radiational cooling, so it will be a little bit chillier. But temperatures will snap back into the 50s during the day. That sunshine, sun angle starting to work now as we head towards March. All right, here's what's going on across the Midwest. Not a whole lot. They got a little additional cloud cover as that storm wraps out of here. The theme for them is we're going to have these clippers. First one's going to sail by them. Second one, later half of the weekend, has a better chance of getting in there as a combination of rain and snow. Before that happens, though, it'll actually be pretty warm in a place like Chicago, getting into the warm sector. We just got a question about snow down in Lubbock. Well, that ain't going to happen anytime soon. Temperatures are going to be warming up eventually. Through the day on Friday, we're going to get a little bit warmer than this. And I think they're a little bit frozen in time. But those are your overnight lows. They will warm up through the day. And then the weekend actually looks pretty mild as they get on the right side of that high. Here's the weekend. Real nice. Got it at Target. 58 in Atlanta, 44 in New York, 54 in Chicago. You know, we talked about the West. They were really counting on this El Nino. It hasn't come through as far as the rain goes. It is nice to visit there right now. It's nice and sunny and temperatures are mild, but it's not good long term. There's that clipper I was talking about coming through here on Sunday. It will be a rain and wind event for Chicago. And Mike, they'll be around 60 degrees.
All right, Keith, thanks for the update. Good looking weekend for a lot of folks there. All right, this evening, as we always do, asking you what you learned on the show. A lot of great knowledge to spread around this evening, don't you think?
Lot reading radar, the next week's storm, lots of stuff, what to do in a severe weather situation.
All right, so let's get to some of your comments this evening, and this is from Cupcake Kisses 7. What I learned today is that a tornado does not sound like a train.
Very good. Yeah. Next one is... There we go.
Dramatic
Skeeter
pause.
Says, understanding the beginner's understanding of how to spot a tornado on Doppler. Still gonna follow Stormmaster's Torcon.
Dr. Forbes, how long? You've been teaching for a long time. How long did you teach at Penn State, by the way?
21 years.
21 years. And you've been teaching here at the Weather Channel for?
16 or more than 16.
16. We learn something every day from Stormmaster G. Good stuff there. All right, let's do one more.
We do.
All right.
Let's bring it up.
All right, so this one, it's coming in from Kay Esters. I learned that South Carolina wasn't the only southern state that didn't have a tornado from Petrus. But actually,
except
with an asterisk, we just found out there was, in fact, an EF0 tornado confirmed in South Carolina. So that you also learned
that
tonight as well. All right. Thank you, everyone, for your comments this evening. Glad that you're enjoying the show and learning something on the show. Well, in tonight's open mic, a death trap on wheels. And I'm not talking your car. This week's tornado outbreak brought dozens of twisters to 9 states. Of the 7 people who died in tornadoes this week, 6 of them were in mobile homes or RVs. Of the 9 total tornado deaths in the U.S. this year, 8 of them have been in mobile homes, all of them in the southern states. That's 89% of all tornado deaths. This number is alarmingly high, but not surprising, since there are more mobile homes in the South than any other region of the country. So, the area of the country that sees the most tornadoes also has the highest number of mobile homes. That's proven to be a deadly combination. It's a matter of economics, really, though. The median sale price of a home in the U.S. is now $214,000. The price of a brand new mobile home, about $65,000. It's affordable, but it's dangerous. It's the last place you should be in severe weather. So let this week be a reminder that alternate shelter is a must. Finding a safe place isn't just a suggestion, it's a mandate. Well, for all of us here at Weather Underground, thank you so much for watching. Have a great night. And remember, together, we know more. Including a sneaky EF0 tornado. Yeah.
And you said earlier, too, they're going to have some EF0 that's going to blow up the state 6 completely.
There, boy.
In almost every corner of the earth.
It's gonna hit the shock.
Watch out.
Every moment of every day.
Damn.
Oh my God.
Cameras are rolling on the most heart-stopping.
Holy s***.
Gut-wrenching.
Hey, stay calm. Stay calm.
Awe-inspiring. Weather out there.
We don't really know how to react.
Look at that, dude.
So we wind up mesmerized.
You can't pull away.
This is reality TV.
You think you know your weather? Our team breaks down the science behind the storm.
You can see the water flowing into the vortex.
Inside the most shocking viral videos that will blow your mind. Extreme conditions can make winter one of the most dangerous times of the year.
The one thing that you're concerned about is the weather, the wind, the snow, the visibility.
That's why when the thermometer plummets, it's always survival of the fittest. April 2015, the start of another climbing season on the south side of Mount Everest. A light spring snow is falling just before noon at base camp.
The ground is shaking.
When a climber's cell phone captures the moment a 7.8 magnitude earthquake strikes.
Whoa! They're not expecting this. They're, you know, trying to relax.
Earthquakes are common here in one of the world's most active seismic zones. This one triggers an avalanche.
Look, 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 look. Do we need to go in the tent?
It is total chaos. Everything from ice and snow to huge boulders and rocks that are coming down at an extremely fast speed.
The climbers throw themselves to the ground in their tent.
And the further to the side you can get, away from the fastest portion of that avalanche, and typically where most of the debris and force is, the more you increase your chances of survival.
Luckily, a boulder shields them from being buried by tons of ice, rocks, and snow.
You may be 6 feet down, you may be 6 inches down, you may be 60 feet down. It depends on the avalanche.
In shock and disbelief, the climbers emerge from a tent that could easily have been their grave.
And we try to find the kitchen tent. Oh no, there's no kitchen tent left.
This day is one of history's deadliest on Everest, with 18 dead and dozens of injured airlifted off the mountain. 8,000 are killed across the Himalayan region. From Everest to Wilhelmina Bay, Antarctica, a magnet for whale watchers and nature lovers. February 2012. Tourists in an inflatable boat take in the beauty of a towering iceberg.
Why don't we just stay here?
In the summer, some of the icebergs, depending on the size of them, they can melt a little bit.
We're watching this iceberg. Look at that cave in there. Boy, you sure would want to get closer here.
Not very much.
That's not going to last for today.
And then suddenly, a shocking sight. A mountain of ice that has survived for centuries, gone.
And the amount of ice that's locked up in Antarctica is tremendous. And it is part of a natural process for these icebergs, these glaciers, to calve or break away into the water.
Natural, but terrifying. The boat is rocked as the tour guide floors the engine to escape. A chunk of ice flies all the way to the camera lens.
When these types of icebergs and that volume of ice and snow implodes down into the water, it can produce a local tidal wave of sorts, a wave that can actually swamp these smaller boats. If you get thrown into that kind of water, now it becomes a life-threatening situation.
Remarkably, no one is hurt. And the remaining iceberg settles into the sea.